Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Guns of Glory on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install Guns of Glory and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Guns of Glory. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all folks, the first thing to do is to launch our favorite web browser. We open the one we prefer. Let's go to this URL I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. You don't need to type the URL, because there's the link in the video description and the first pinned comment. We landed here on the website of Usitility, in which we include a detailed overview on how to download Guns of Glory on computer. We scroll down a little bit and click on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on the link, we arrive here on the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will load to enjoy the game Guns of Glory on PC. As you can see here, we access some pros of running that emulator. Now we will start downloading the Guns of Glory by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green. We then click on this button. And the download takes no time at all. Here it is, here is located the download. It is an executable file. What we are going to do is to run the installer, so we click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make modifications to the device. We answered yes. I minimize the browser to find the installer significantly better. The installer is very simple to use. It contains two choices, install and setup path. I will make it clear what setup path does. We simply click on it. And therefore we see that we have here the path where the emulator will be put in. If we prefer to change this directory, we need to click on the browse button. Therefore we decide on another directory and install the emulator where we choose. To keep it simple, just leave it by default. I simply click on back. And I click on install. Now, there it is. The installation begins and it will move forward in the download of all these megabytes that happens to be displayed on that screen. The moment you download it, it might possibly be more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed may go faster or slower, subject to your internet and according to the data transfer rate of the emulator servers. Today they are going superbly fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. Now, the emulator has been started automatically. As you can see, down here, there's a progress bar that will fill up then when it has reached the ending, the emulator will be launched for the first time. In reality, the emulator has already been started, here it is for the first time. Before we continue, as you can discover, it has made two software icons right here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon is the one we are considering. At any time when we are planning to operate Guns of Glory on our laptop or computer, we double-click on this specific icon and therefore launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let's do the following step, which is a requirement, and this is to visit the Google Play Store. And we'll click on Play Store. As you can discover, the Google Play is launched. Right here we have to log on. At this moment when we're here, we have to perform the next phase which is obligatory. Therefore we simply click on, sign in. Now it says, checking info. It could sometimes get blocked in, checking info, additionally it does not proceed. If so, you can attempt to log in after a couple of hours and it may almost certainly be corrected. Now we are going to insert our email and password. The email really needs to be a Gmail email and its related password. For example, you may use the same exact email you're using at this time in your YouTube account. So I am going to provide my data and I'll come back when I have accomplished it. That's it, data typed in. Here is Google welcoming us and supplying us their terms of service. We would accept them simply by hitting, I agree. Next, it offers us to save to the Google Cloud. You can let it select it and it will generate a backup of the data on this device to Google Drive. I am not going to check it, you do what you want. We click on accept. Google Play is launched automatically and automatically. To set up the video game, we would need to go to the emulator desktop for Android by clicking on this icon indicated in green. Now that we are on the desktop of this emulator, we notice that we have now there the install game button. We just click on the button. Here we have the game app. So let's press now on the install button that I'm displaying now in green. And it will start the software installation. At this moment it would download and install the game. It may take some time or it could possibly be almost immediate. It again all relies on our own web connection. It has already finished setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by clicking on this particular button that I'm emphasizing in green, in order to launch Guns of Glory for the first time. We are already on the emulator desktop, and therefore we are preparing to mouse click on the new Guns of Glory software icon that has been created. The game is started for the first time. Now there we get it, I can mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will comment on the volume level of the emulator. It's right here. We use the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume, this way we won't rely on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of the emulator. And to enjoy the experience to the maximum, we can switch on the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. This is the first one, we click on this particular software icon that I'm pointing out in green. And the screen is maximized, coming with one border on top, one at the right and one at the bottom. In case we desire to experience the game using all the screen, we press on that icon. And consequently we would at present be enjoying the game app in 100% screen function. To exit the complete screen mode, push the F11 key. And we'd at present be in regular display screen mode. Now I am going to present you the keyboard mapping that is definitely very helpful. This means we will certainly be capable to play the game application much more easily. The first task is to click on this keyboard icon. And there you will be able to get the necessary configuration settings. I most certainly will leave the normal configuration, but if you like to modify this, you may very well do so without any problem. Clearly, the emulator is completely in our own language. Sometimes it occurs that your emulator is presented in the wrong language, for example, in Chinese language. And consequently, to set it in the proper language we browse here to the cogwheel. And here inside of other options, we mouse click on the language drop down. We could choose the language we like, Spanish, Mandarin, etc. As soon as the language is selected, we should save, the emulator would restart, and the game app, the next time we use it, would also be in the preferred language. At this moment, there is another element that we must take into consideration, and it's that we will receive an email saying that a brand new machine has been linked to this Google account. It definitely will question us if we are the individuals who have connected that device. Yup, we may not worry, because the emulator is acting as an Android tablet or smartphone. And to see which smartphone or tablet is being emulated, we return right here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. Let's go here to the model option. And there we see that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for that tutorial. I anticipate you enjoyed it, especially that you found it helpful. If that is so, offer it a pleasant thumb up, subscribe, and any comments, questions or suggestions, let them in the comment box down below. You could even comment things on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams ever so often, you have it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Simply click any of those video tutorials which are usually showing up on the screen and see you in the following videos. Bye.